bike ride to Freestone, California. We're gonna stop at the famous Wildflower Bakery and take some photos. It's a really scenic spot in West Sonoma County. I'm going to be riding the steel touring bike. And the reason we're going to go to Wildflower Bakery is because Wildflower Bakery is in a very scenic area of West Sonoma County, but more importantly, they offer vegan pastries, which is kind of rare, actually. You'd be surprised. I would think in Sonoma County, being kind of a progressive area, that there would be more vegan options, but there really isn't. So today I'm gonna go over there and get a vegan pastry. To get to Freestone, we're not gonna go the direct way. We're gonna go up Harrison Grade Road, which is a nice little climb. It's pretty steep, but with proper gearing, it's manageable. It's not that long, but then from there we'll drop into Occidental, California, and then from there we can drop down to Freestone. So there's a lot of downhill coming up. So somebody asked me recently when I adopted how long ago did I adopt a plant-based diet? And I thought I would mention that in this video since we're riding over to Freestone to order a pastry that's made out of plants, and we're still not quite to the climb yet, so it's a good time to mention some of these things. So actually I'm going to do this descent first and then I'll come back and I'll mention how I got started on a plant-based diet. I got started on a plant-based diet in 2010, and I first switched to what is called a vegetarian diet. And that included dairy and eggs, but I just excluded meat, and I switched to kind of a whole foods approach. Immediately, I saw benefits, health benefits, and athletic benefits. And so I sort of stuck to that diet for about 3 years. And then in 2013, I had noticed continuous improvement by eating more plants and less dairy and eggs. And I slowly phased those two things out completely. We're just gonna get up here where I'm not going downhill so fast because I know there's wind blowing all over the camera. Animal products were not providing significant health benefits at all. And so I just completely removed them all. There were moments where I accidentally bought things that unknowingly had butter in it or egg products of some sort, because I wasn't paying that close attention. The bulk of my diet removed the majority of the animal products, so I wasn't too concerned. But then when I realized that the plant-based diet was such a healthy approach, the ethical end of it slowly became more obvious to me. But anyway, we're coming up to the Harrison Grade climb, so I want to show you that, give you a chance to see. It's quite pretty out here, and for the most part, there's not tons of traffic. Weekends are going to be busier than weekdays, so if you do decide to take a ride out here, I would recommend weekdays, but weekends aren't bad. It's Sunday today, and it's noon, so ideal times are obviously in the morning. Earlier the better, but that's not always possible that maybe with this perspective you can see what the angle of inclination is. Here's the start of it right here. So if I keep the camera level, you should be able to kind of get a gauge of the gradient. We're on Harrison Grade Road. Need to make a left to go to Occidental. Oh, it's pretty much a few little rollers after this, and then it's a drop into Occidental. Harrison Grade Road is about a 7 to 10 minute climb. So if you're riding a lightweight road bike, you should be able to zip up that hill pretty easily. I do think a compact crankset is better for that climb. It's not super, super steep, but standard gearing would be, it would grind, you'd be grinding a little bit too much. So you're probably noticing there's a lot of vineyards around here. And I think it'd be for the wine connoisseur who might be watching this, this region, this appellation is the Russian River Valley appellation. Many of the grapes you see here and in this video as I'm riding are typically Pinot Noir and Chardonnay, but there are other varieties that do grow out here, but those seem to be the two main varieties that grow the best in this climate. So anyway, I thought I'd mention that in case you were curious what is going on. Freestone is just right there. You know you're getting close to a bakery when you're in Sonoma County by all the cars that are parked along the rural roadways. I think it's safe to say Wildflower Bakery has been discovered. When you leave Freestone and make a left and head back towards Sevastopol, you don't want to go all the way into Sevastopol on Bodega Highway. Instead, what you want to do is come up here to Barnett Valley Road and make a right on Barnett Valley Road. And then I'll show you where to take the next turn to get you back into Sevastopol on the back roads. This road's pretty busy. Although it has a big shoulder here, it gets very narrowed down. And as you can see, there's a lot of traffic today on the Bodega Highway. Okay, so when you get to this intersection, you want to make a left on Burnside Road. And that way, you can head back into Sevastopol the quickest way. And this is a good road. It's obviously been resealed here recently, but it's a pretty quiet road. Thank you. got back from the Freestone bakery ride. I do regret it now, looking back. I should have videotaped the inside, and so you could see the brick oven. So Freestone has a pretty cool bakery inside. There's a wood-fired oven, brick oven, and the way everything's set up is really cool. All the breads kind of stacked up on top of each other, and it's quite a sight to see that much bread. And it's pretty cool that they have such a large customer base that they're able to do that. Luna, do you want to go to the nectary? Huh? You want to go to the nectary? Okay, let's go.
Mm-hmm.